In this video, we will summarize some of the most common useful tips and tricks in FLL robot programming that every FLL team should know. We have gathered most of these helpful ideas from FLL teams and online sources. First, we would like to start with program selection. The usual way is to run each program independently. However, it is better to combine programs into one program. Then each sub-program can be executed separately as a custom block. It reduces sub-program starting time. This way, you can run your robot with the corresponding brick buttons. This code illustrates the idea. If the brick is not easily accessible like this, or you want to run a mission depending on the sensor readings, you can use the color sensor and the push buttons. When you press the external touch button, the switch block reads the sensor color data and runs the necessary sub-program. Also, you could go for a more advanced option where the next program automatically loads up after the previous program is finished, and scrolling through programs is also possible. For step-by-step instructions on how to do it, search FLL Master Program, or you can click the link in the description below. Next, we would like to talk about gyro usage. Every FLL team had experienced problems with robot movement accuracy. Either the robot is not moving straight, or the robot is not turning as intended. The gyro sensor can significantly help in these situations. Some FLL participants complained about the gyro sensor inaccuracy. It might glitch in some cases, but overall it works well. You just need to know how to use it properly. For example, the calibration. There are two ways on how to calibrate your gyro sensor. First is the startup calibration. When the Lego brick is starting up, the attached gyro sensor is being calibrated. At this moment, it is possible to mess up the sensor by moving it while it is calibrating. Do not move the robot while starting up unless you plan to calibrate the sensor using the software. Second is the software calibration. When you change the sensor reading mode, then it recalibrates itself. Recalibration takes up to a few seconds. If you want to know when it is finished, you need to add a delay block that waits until the sensor value is zero, because while the sensor is calibrating, it returns a non-value, which means not a number. When you use the software calibration method, do not move the robot while the calibration is ongoing. Please keep in mind that the gyro sensor reset function does not calibrate the sensor. It nullifies the current sensor reading. For example, if the previous sensor reading is 47, then after resetting, the current reading will be zero. When the gyro sensor is calibrated, we can start using it in my block to make it run straightforward. Our custom block has two inputs, rotation and power. We can store the gyro reading as a starting direction into a variable, and then measure the gyro sensor reading again and compare it against the starting direction. The difference of the current gyro reading and the starting direction can be used as input for the steering block to keep the robot move in a straight direction. If you are not doing any actions in parallel with the gyro sensor block, then it is possible to simplify the straight movement of the robot by resetting the gyro sensor every time the robot path changes its direction. The sensor reading will be equal to the deviation from the gyro reset value, which is zero. But before passing the sensor reading value to the steering block, you need to invert it by multiplying it by -1. Next, let's learn how to do precise turns. If the robot is running a long distance with many turns in its path, then it is extremely important to minimize the error in each turn. To achieve that, we can use the gyro sensor. If you will set the robot to turn in an angle of x degrees, it is very likely that it will turn more than x degrees because of momentum and other factors. But it is possible to achieve an accuracy of 1 degree or even higher by using the gyro sensor. The turning accuracy can be increased by using the following algorithm. Reset the gyro sensor, then turn the robot till it reaches, for example, 2/3 of the target angle. After that, turn with slow speed until it reaches the desired turning angle. The turning angle will depend on the turning speed, tire size, robot mass, and other factors. The algorithm can be implemented as my block with input parameters like turning angle, fast speed, and slow speed. When building your own precise turning block, you will have to calibrate all these values for your robot. Our custom block is only designed to turn in one direction. To turn it in another direction, you can make another block like this one, or improve the same one, including both directions. Also, it is possible to build a turning block that will gradually decrease the robot's speed. This and more ideas for building your own precise turning blocks can be found by searching EV3 Accurate Turns. Sometimes, you can use black lines on the board as a guide. It is important to use a good line following code so that the robot will not wobble. For instructions on how to make a line follower PID program, please click the link in the description below. Sometimes, it is useful to run the robot to the wall to make its position perpendicular to the wall or use the wall as a reference to know the robot location on the board. It is possible to make the robot stop running when it hits an obstacle. The collision can be detected by using the sensors built in the motors. The main idea is that you turn the motor on and then calculate the motor rotation difference after a small period. If the difference is zero, then we have detected that it has not moved. A step-by-step guide can be found in the link in the description below. It is possible to use this idea to detect when the robot is perpendicular to the wall. The code is like in the previous example, but this time, both motors are processed in parallel. When one of the motors stalls, the other motor still spins until it stalls too. If both motors stall, the program loop stops too. It takes some time to find the best parameter values like motor speed. The slower the robot moves, the easier it is to detect when the motor stalls. Do you have other tricks you want to share? Write us in the comments.